Hey guys, I'm Tyler and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to be making this Lazy Susan table centerpiece thingy, I guess. This is made out of solid cherry. It does have a bearing in it so you can rotate it around. It's a little bit sticky right now. And we made it so it has a removable centerpiece, which for right now happens to be a Christmas tree that the kids and I put together. But you can put anything you want on there, whether it be with the seasons or maybe just with the table setting that you want at that time. We will be giving this away to one lucky winner along with a pair of Carolina boots, who is the sponsor of today's video. Let's get to building this thing. This project is going to start with this very gnarly cherry. This slab is just over 2 inches thick, and as you can see, it is very, very warped. So over here on the bandsaw, I'm going to break it down into some more manageable pieces that are 6 inches wide so that I can run it through the jointer and get one flat face. And then we'll go back to the bandsaw to resaw it down to slightly over half an inch. Then we'll take it over to the planer and mill it down nice and flat and square to 1/2 inch. Interesting little tidbit that I didn't notice until I was cutting this up, but that is the pith of the big log, and that always is going to be your point of cracking. And look at that, that just tore itself apart right there. And the slab on either side is in relatively good shape, a little bit twisted, but no big cracks. So you always want to try to cut out the pith if you can. This happens to be one of the best shots I've ever gotten that explains the magic of a jointer. Here you can see how twisted this piece is. It's basically riding on the front and back corner. But after several passes over the jointer, which is taking off a little bit on each of those corners, you will have a perfectly flat piece. Basically, a jointer allows you to take junk and turn it into a treasure. Alright, so we got everything milled down to proper size. This is going to be the base. These are right over 1/2 inch thick at the moment. I'm going to rip these down to 15 1/4, so when we glue the three of them together, we have a base that is 15 3/4 in diameter. And these are going to be the Lazy Susan itself. And these are just over 1 inch at the moment, and I'm going to rip them down to 5 inches wide so that in the end the base overhangs the turntable itself a little bit, and then we can round that over, giving it a nice profile up to the top. This is a new tool in my shop, and my goodness, I don't know what I did without a drum sander for so long. I got this as I have a ton of drawers and door faces to make for the new addition on the house,
But like I said, I don't know what I did without this thing. It is so great. In this particular situation, the two boards that I needed to flatten out are wider than my planer, so I could slide them over to this 16-inch wide drum sander and flatten them right up. After they were flat, it was back over to the bandsaw to cut them into circles.
So this is the bearing that I'm using for the rotation, same bearings that I used for the mega rotating shoe rack, heavy duty bearings. And I'm going to recess them into the bottom and to the top so that we get a like 1-inch gap between instead of this big gap right here. And I'm using a quick little circle cutting jig that I made on the trim router. And I'm using the trim router because my bigger router, I don't have a 1/4-inch collet for. Mounting the bearing has definitely been a little bit tricky. Like I said, we recessed it so that we could get the two boards very, very close together. And I have since tapped the bottom side of this bearing so that we can then countersink some screws from the bottom and mount this one. What I'm going to do is drill some through holes and countersink into the bearing itself so I can put the screws in here and they won't rub on this side. And then I will actually drill and tap into this cherry board. And the sequence of assembly will be mount it to the top and then take the whole thing and mount it to the bottom board.
I cut out this quick template using my jigsaw, and I am going to use that with a bearing bit on the router to dado out some pockets in this Lazy Susan centerpiece so that you can put your salt, pepper, and different condiments in there and they won't slide off. And what a disaster of a job. I do wish that I took slightly shallower passes so the router wouldn't have tried to jump so much. And I understand most people don't have a CNC in their shop, but if I did, I would have cut the template out using that, and that would have reduced some of these waves that I'm sanding down right now on the side of the piece. But I sanded them down with a drum insert on my drill, and then chamfered them over using my cordless router. A quick round over on the tops of both the base and the top piece, and then it was on to some finish. For the finish, I used 3 coats of General Finishes Enduro Var. I went with the Enduro Var instead of Armor Seal, which would be my typical for this hardwood, as I wanted it to dry a little bit faster so I could move on. And I need to be reminded again and again never to brush a finish. It's just such a waste of time. Here I'm trying to pick out bristles from the cheap brush that I was using, and in the end, I actually ended up spraying the last coat so that I would get a nice smooth finish. Always spray.
Just so happens to be Christmas season 2018 right now, so I'm going to be making a Christmas tree out of segmented circles to go on top of this Lazy Susan turntable. I'm going to be making it out of 3/4-inch thick poplar because it will be painted by the kids, and I will need 13 segments to get me roughly 10 inches, and we will cut all the squares out on the table saw, and then we'll move over to the bandsaw with the circle cutting jig.
I got all the squares cut out to make the Christmas tree, and if I would have had half a brain working at this point in time, I would have not needed all these different squares, because as I cut the circles out and cut the inside out of the circle, I would have had the circle for the next piece. So I only ended up using like 3 or 4 of the bigger squares. Definitely need a very thin blade on your bandsaw when cutting radii this small, so I changed over to a 1/4-inch fine tooth blade and got it nice and tight and cut out my circles using my DIY circle cutting jig. And here you can see once I cut the inside of the circle out, I can use that inside to cut the next circle. And there were quite a few circles to cut. I then went back and inserted some glue and clamped together the segments where the interior cut line was. So I glued that together, and once those are dry, I glued together the entire cone to make the Christmas tree stack.
Well, there. No way. Whoa.
Looking good. Once it was dry, I moved over to my pop-up paint booth and sprayed a couple coats of Hunter Green spray paint. And then with the kids' help, we hot glued on some red beads to act as ornaments for the Christmas tree. Now that our two platters are complete, along with the Christmas tree, it is time for assembly. I used some side cutters to cut some screws a little bit shorter so that they wouldn't protrude through the bearing, and then threaded everything together.
Well, there you are, folks. I hope you enjoyed this video. Not a very complicating build, but definitely something pretty cool. And with the removable centerpiece, you can put a Christmas tree on there. You can put your napkins in the middle if you would like that. Or if you really like your Carolina boots that much, you can put them right in the middle of the table too. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hammer that thumbs up button. Helps us out a ton and gets this video in front of more eyes. I'm DIY Tyler, and you guys have a good one. Let's get this out of here. Like I mentioned at the beginning of this video has been brought to us by Carolina Boots. I've talked in the past about my lace-up work boots, which I wear in the shop almost every day, but today I want to talk to you about these big old mutter boots that I have. I got a pair for my brothers and my dad, and we absolutely love them. For this time of year where it's kind of in the middle of being warm and cold and it's just disgusting outside, these things are great. These don't happen to be insulated, but you can get insulated boots from Carolina as well. I'm sure they're great for the snow. Until the end of this year, 12/31/18, if you follow the link down in the description below and use the code DIYTyler15, you can get 15% off your very own pair of boots. Again, that offer only lasts until the end of this year, 12/31. So follow that link down in the description below. Get your very own pair of boots today. You will not regret it.